Generations, millennials are an important spending target. We are just obsessed with old stuff. All we want is stuff from the past, then they'll just repackage new stuff to look like stuff from the past.
Well, could there be anything more accurate for sneakers right now, especially when it comes to Jordan retros? Now, that's one of my favorite channels to watch. I will definitely link them below, Future Proof, because they take a dive into various different topics and just consumer behavior, but also looking at it from a business perspective and why brands or companies may do what they do. But it makes sense. It really does. Now, he also touches in that video on the fact that millennials, we are, because I am a millennial. I know people seem to assume that like I'm Gen Z because I did a video around Gen Z and the fact that Nike has really lost that demographic. They've lost that generation. Well, really, they just never fully got them to like buy in, and they're still really young, so you can still capture their attention. But people assume that I'm Gen Z because I stood up for them. Listen, in some instances, yes, I will stand up for them. I will defend them because there are things in which they do that are very logical. They make sense. And then there are other times where I got nothing for you. Have you seen this video?
Here's a, I'm an idiot and here's why. My laundry machine takes quarters. Naturally, I'm like, where does one just get quarters? So I'm like, okay, I'm gonna go on Amazon and buy quarters. You can buy like rolls of quarters on Amazon. I'm like, perfect, I'll do that. And I was like, 72 rolls for $10? That the math doesn't equal up, but that's a score. Like I'm getting 72 rolls of quarter sleeves with quarters in them for $10. Like, I'm like, okay, stupid. Amazon's losing money. Get the package. Empty. It's just 72 plain.
This has to be partly on the parents and the schools. The schools are open. The children need to be in them, but teachers can only do so much. So parents, this is on you. Please just educate the kids, okay? Like, even if you were one of Bush's children, we should have left behind. Try. Make an effort. We are all in society with your children, all right? But back to this video. So for millennials, yes, we have like the highest buying power, which of course is why brands are stuck on giving us whatever it is that we may want. Now they can give some, they give some, not all, okay? There's truly like a, we're gonna listen to you somewhat, not all the way. And then even when they do listen, people still aren't happy. I've said this in numerous videos. Sneakerheads are never happy. You are never content. So brands should just continue to sometimes do what it is that they want to do because you guys will complain anyway. It doesn't matter. But yes, we have a lot of buying power because we are in this age range where we are finally earning more money. I know it may not always feel that way. We certainly have, you know, more income at this stage in our lives, and you know, it may be thwarted a little bit if you do have kids. They will take up a very big chunk of your income, but a lot of us don't have children, and that's just not something that will be a part of my life. So there's certainly disposable income there, which means brands want us to buy in. Like, they want to capture us as loyal consumers, and Jordan Brand and Nike did that to so many of us when we were really young. I mean, before we could ever afford or buy our own shoes, we were bugging our parents. We had the East Bay magazine. You circle what you want. You fold the page over. You have sticky notes and tabs. I'm not saying I did any of this. I'm just throwing some things out there, okay? And we were begging our parents to please, 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 right? I want the retro, I want the Jordan. Either you saw Jordan play in them, or maybe you were just kind of indoctrinated into this sneaker culture based on family members, friends, uncles, aunts, okay? Very much so like some of us do right now with the younger generation. We were bought in at an early age, and one easy recipe for success, because Jordan Brand and Nike are showing this, don't deviate away from what they're still asking for. The nostalgia is there. They want back what possibly they couldn't have, right? Because for a lot of us growing up in that 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, and on, we were still quite young. So maybe we had those shoes or we saw them, but not necessarily for us to wear and enjoy as we would like to. So this is your chance to really be a part of it. And so you want those retros to come back out, because even though retros have, you know, been a thing for so many years, you may have still been in school or you were in college, which means you were probably a broke college student, so you couldn't even afford a lot of the retros that came out. So this is the time in life where you finally can do the things you want to do with your money. And I only ask that you do them in a very smart and conscientious way, okay? Not buying sneakers on credit cards, okay? Not if you're not going to pay that bill in full. If you pay the bill in full, then awesome, and, you know, enjoy those rewards. But if that's not the case, then please let's not, you know, spend 33% on the shoes extra, like to Discover and MasterCard and Visa and anyone else that you would possibly have a credit card through. Let's not do that, okay? But they can understand as a brand, oh, you just want what you couldn't have in the past. Let's just repackage it. Is this not what they did, like, bar for bar with the Air Jordan 1 Black Toe? Like, bar for bar, this is truly what they did, right? Taking it back to even having Air Jordan on the side. Now, I know that's a hit or miss for people. And please, comment below, where do you stand? Is it a hit for you to have the Air Jordan on the side? And I know it has, you know, very intentional packaging. I also understand we don't wear the packaging outside, okay? So take that part out of it. Or are you against having Air Jordan on the side? Do you just want your Wings logo and that's it? What's been working great? Don't fix it. Don't alter it. Please go ahead and comment that below, because they did this bar for bar and they've done this close to one-to-one for so many different pairs, and we've seen reimagined, and it can go one of two ways. You love it or you hate it. But this is exactly what Jordan Brand has done. That's why I laughed as soon as I was watching the video. I go, oh no, I gotta sit down and just give my quick thoughts. This here is what we're seeing with Jordan retros. The nostalgia is, I think, the blueprint right now, at least for millennials and probably Gen X. For Gen Z, that's not really going to work for them. So brands are scrambling to connect with Gen Z, and some are doing a great job, whether it is ASICS. Crocs continue to do a really great job. I think New Balance also with like the 9060 still is something that Gen Z is very much so into. And then we have a lot of millennials and Gen X where you're still looking for the Nike retros and the different runners, right? These retro runners are speaking to us. I don't know if you guys saw like the latest Pegasus release. I think that's a gorgeous shoe. I really do. I think it's an amazing release, and I think it will be well received. Now, don't hold me to that, but I think it will be well received. You guys know I love anything that is more of that beige, off-white, sail tone. I don't apologize for that. I think it's great as like kind of that debut colorway. And I think they have like a triple black. So, I mean, you know, that's how you get down. That's how you get down. But they're certainly playing on the nostalgia. Now, for all of us, that isn't working, because once you've been there, done that, I may not need to, you know, spend the block on the shoe that is an exact same shoe of what I've already had. And that's really how I feel looking ahead to 2025. There's so much that I get. It's coming back around. I wasn't pulled to need it then. And even if I respected it then, I can respect it now. It doesn't mean that I need to spend my money on it, and certainly not retail. Why? Well, if you wait like 5 business days, a shoe usually goes on sale now. Great times that we're in, except that's going to pose some difficulty for Nike and Jordan. So with Elliot Hill at the helm, time for him to get to work on that. Please go ahead and comment your thoughts below. Just did you get a good laugh out of that whole nostalgia bit? Again, share your thoughts on the black toe. Now, we know that that's been pushed back. So if you are going for that, you got a little bit more time to be able to save, unless boutiques are still going to drop. I have no idea. If you're curious on how I would style a black toe, well, I have the black toe low. I have the Air Jordan 1 Black Toe Low, so you can check that video out. I'll be sure to put it in the description box of this one. And please also just check out Quick Styling and On Foot for the Adidas Samba XLG. I like to think of it as the Grande Latte. As always, act your age, not your shoe size. Peace.